this is just not just an ordinary chip.
Uh-huh.
It's called a sensor.
Uh-huh.
It's actually helping you
uh-huh.
to tackle so many problems that you cannot be able to see with your own eyes. She is doing 34 liters a day.
Wow. 34 liters?
Yes. And she is in the second lactation.
Wow, man. That's a lot of milk.
Yes. You just feed your cow with junk.
Yeah.
And even call a live band here to sing for this cow.
Sauti Sol or yeah. Jay-Z.
Yeah. Tell me how much milk you are going to produce in the farm.
Not much.
The secret is the bread.
Food.
That radio is the person who is working in the farm.
Oh, yeah, to motivate you.
Motivate. First, need to have that zeal, passion.
Mm.
What will it eat for the next one season?
Mm.
That means from 1 to 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
You must have plenty of fodder, of genetics you want to come up with.
Mm.
Then after genetics, you have proper management. After that, you improvise on technology.
You come to tech.
Then you're good to go.
And you're having some incredible tech here.
When you feed your animal, you must convert it to milk.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, this cow, that is the longest process in the system of a dairy animal.
Wow. Converting food
in fermentation method,
uh-huh.
then from there, converting that to milk. And that is the longest process in a dairy cow.
Yeah.
So if it is the longest process, why then can't you shorten?
Ah, now I'm seeing sense in everybody saying silage, silage, silage. I'm here, I'm just enjoying standing here because this food smells really nice, man.
Yeah.
I feel like you can serve me and I eat with them, man.
Yeah.
Wow. Now, let's go to management. What is your day routine? The labor. Take us through that.
Number one, as I told you initially, you, as the owner of the farm, you are the manager. And you are the CEO
of the farm.
And you are the security
of the farm.
Personnel of the farm.
Wow.
So everything is you.
Mm.
Number two, whoever comes after you is called a second hand assistant.
Mm-hmm.
The farm belongs to you.
Mm.
You are the one to know which, where, when, and why to do things differently.
Mm-hmm.
If you fail on management, you fail in everything. Because if you ask me, this one eats how much? This one eats how much? I'll tell you.
You know.
I know.
Mm.
And my work is to make sure that I have enough and plenty of fodder for these animals.
Mm.
That is my work.
That is everything. That is the objective.
I have workers, some permanent.
Yeah.
And we work on the two of us. And we are comfortable.
You're forgetting your apps, your AI. We'll come to that later.
That will come later.
Yeah.
Wow. That one will come to tell us. Yeah. Are you doing it right?
Appropriately.
Thank you.
Are you getting this wrong? No, you've gotten this wrong. Do this now.
Do this.
Okay.
Because the bottom line is milk.
Yeah.
So for you to get enough milk, you really need to do good things for these animals.
Wow.
Like now they have already eaten. Now they want to go and drink water.
Yeah.
And have enough sleep.
Eat, drink, sleep.
Drink, sleep.
Talking of sleep, and I'm seeing, by the way, nice mats over there. It's as if they're the ones I do yoga with. I think
the person who brought up these mattress, I think it was a lifestyle.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
What do you mean by that?
It was a high-class lifestyle of cows.
Uh-huh.
But it doesn't add milk.
Uh-huh.
It is not comfortable.
So those ones are not, you're telling me those ones are not comfortable. Nah, he's going to sleep immediately after opening.
Yes, but it's not comfortable.
What do you mean it's not?
You see the body of a cow?
Yeah.
It's sponge-like.
Uh-huh.
Look at the under. We have fro. Yeah. It's solid.
It's solid. It's hard.
The matrix is on the solid.
Yeah.
It's also solid. It's not that puffy.
So it's not that good?
Ah, it's not.
You're thinking of putting mattress?
No, a mattress.
What?
A sawdust.
Oh, so you put sawdust
to have warm?
Uh-huh.
And much more comfortable than a mattress.
Wow. So you add sawdust on top of that?
Yes.
You're giving them more comfort?
Yes.
Wow. These cows are living a better life, man.
If you don't do that, you don't get it right.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And tell me this. When I came in, when you were milking, you had put all the tails up. Why? Yeah.
You know, sometimes
they swerve, they hit
you on the face.
The only reason for that is to prevent
and number two
disturbance. Yeah.
When you're milking, we don't just wash the teats.
Uh-huh.
We wash the entire under.
Yeah.
With warm water and soap.
Yeah.
That is it. By doing that, cleaning lens.
Yeah, it's paramount. Very clean, man. This farm.
And number two,
so clean. Yeah,
you prevent mastitis.
Uh huh.
Because by applying soap and washing the entire under with warm water and soap, you actually kill and destroy
bacteria germs around.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
That's a secret.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so the whole point of when you milk, I've seen you milk, you take the milk, you go wait, you record it.
Each cow individually.
Individually.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I know each cow produces what. So if there is a drop of milk, you have a question mark. Why?
What is happening?
If there is an increase, why? So your mathematics is simple. There's something I train, which call farm audit.
Farm auditing.
Wow. Farm auditing.
Yeah.
What are the inputs and the outputs?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow.
So that you do something we call agri business.
Agri business. How many times? Because this farm is so clean. How many times do you wash it a day?
Twice.
Twice a day.
Because this cow is not here to produce manure.
It's here to have a clean environment
to produce milk.
To produce milk.
Yes.
So you're making
good feeding. Good feeding.
Uh-huh.
Less manure.
Wow. Uh-huh.
And even when you focus the manure,
uh-huh,
it's precisely fine.
Uh-huh.
There's no garbage in and garbage out.
Yeah. Wow. And I noticed that.
Yes.
What about the little bit of manure that you get? Of course it has to.
It has to go out.
Yeah, to go out.
Yeah.
The fine product.
Yeah.
So, how do you manage the manure? I feel like we are in a residential place. You're keeping a lot of cows, meaning you'll be having quite some amount of manure, okay?
Yeah.
And manure isn't the best smelling, okay?
Yeah.
Now, here, because the food smells good, I'm not even feeling the smell of the manure, okay? So how do you manage it? Why am I not feeling it? Why are the neighbors not complaining?
Good management.
Yeah.
You that's why I told you initially.
Yeah.
You are the manager.
Uh-huh.
And this is your farm.
Wow.
What else do you expect?
It has
you to are be, the CEO and you are
have
the
to
security.
Make it the best.
You
because it's yours.
It's yours. Everything is well managed.
Amazing. Amazing. So do you sell the manure?
No.
Where does it go?
No, that's for Napier and for my image signage.
You plant your own
Napier? Yes.
Wow, that is incredible. Wow. Now, let's get off management. We come to tech. And that's the gist of it. That is what the missing link. And all these factors have to work together. Tech, feeding, genetics, management.
Now, this is what you're talking about.
Uh-huh. Ruth, this one is Ruth.
Yeah.
Yes. Come closer, come closer. Yeah, I'm seeing the collar. They have something in the... First of all, they're having a collar.
Yes.
Very rare to have a cow. That's the first thing I noticed. There's a collar. You mean like, you're putting a collar on a cow? And then I came closer, I'm like, wow, no, there's something on this collar. What is that?
This is another hand.
Your farm hand?
Yes. That is another technology.
Wow, tell us about this technology.
This is a new technology being introduced in Kenya.
Uh-huh.
Actually, I'm the first farmer in Kenya to have this.
Wow.
We have we are doing a collaboration with the Korean government.
You're partnering with Korean government?
Yes.
Wow, that's incredible. Kenyan government. And the government of Kenya.
So we have Korea,
uh-huh.
And we have Kenya.
Kenya.
And now me, I'm the link of the two.
Wow, man.
So very soon,
yeah,
this program,
yeah,
and this technology,
uh-huh,
will be launched officially,
uh-huh,
by the Kenyan government.
Uh-huh.
That's why the importance of this,
yeah,
this just not just an ordinary chip.
Yeah, uh-huh.
It's called a sensor.
Uh huh.
It's actually helping you.
Uh huh.
To tackle so many problems that you cannot be able to see with your own eyes.
Yeah.
Before this cow is sick,
uh-huh,
this one is going to alert you.
To tell you she's going to get sick.
She has a problem.
Uh-huh.
Before even you see the signs and the symptoms.
Uh-huh.
For instance, if this cow starts coughing,
mm,
you have an, it actually sends an immediate alert in your mobile.
Wow.
It tells you
she's Mary, called Mary. Mary. This Mary.
It will send you an alert and tells you, Mary, she is coughing.
Hey man.
And
Mary,
how many times?
Good. Yeah.
And at what interval?
Uh-huh.
So by that, you know there is a problem.
Mm.
But you see with your own naked eyes,
she's good.
She's good.
Yeah.
Number two.
Yeah.
How will you be able to identify if this cow has eaten enough?
Uh-huh.
The same, you will look at the app and it will tell you how many times, minutes, seconds, and milliseconds she took when she was eating. Standing and eating. For how long is this cow standing? And for how long is this cow sitting?
Uh-huh.
So if this cow is standing a lot,
mm-hmm,
you have a problem with your baby.
Oh, she doesn't want to go to sleep.
And a cow produces milk when she is lying fair.
Wow.
Not standing.
Wow.
And another thing.
Uh-huh.
When it comes to diseases,
uh-huh,
it sends you an immediate alert, uh-huh, to tells you the cow has a problem. And you see, these cows, a lot of problems comes from feeding.
Uh-huh.
If your cow has a problem with the rumination,
uh-huh,
it sends a caution sign.
It's able to know how much time this food is spending in there.
Yes, you'll be able to see the movement.
Uh-huh.
Of the rumen,
all that in your app on your phone.
On the app,
what does the app use?
Internet,
so
Wi-Fi.
That this you have all
there's
that.
There's the Wi-Fi. There's a server there.
Wow.
So very soon,
yeah,
this technology is coming officially in Kenya
and to Africa.
Into Africa.
Wow.
Officially,
we've been hearing of AI now. Tech.
This is the technology.
Now this is tech. Wow.
So before she's sick,
uh-huh,
you can be able to know what to do before even you see the signs and the symptoms.
Amazing. Look at how look at how nice she looks, man.
Yeah, she's already in calf.
Uh-huh.
6 months in calf.
So 3 months then she gives birth.
Yeah, not 3 months. We're talking about 1 month.
Wow, and this is something you told me. Those heifers, you only have to raise a heifer for 2 years and then she's in Calf again.
Yes.
Man, that is crazy.
From born.
Cows, they need to take longer, man.
No. It's 1 year.
Yeah.
It's 12 months.
Wow.
13, 14 months. That heifer actually acquires 300 to 350 kilos.
Wow.
And it's a lot of work.
Wow.
Then 2 years after birth, she's calving down.
Wow. That is incredible.
That's 2 years and outmost 2 years, 2 months or 1 month.
Wow. Now, let's come to this now because you won't miss challenges, right?
Challenges are all over.
So what challenges have you noticed?
Number one challenge is about, you know, the government is keeping telling us we plant trees, global warming.
Oh, global warming.
When it comes to drought season, we face a lot of problems.
How?
That's why I decided to be the silage master.
Wow. I see.
In my farm, 1 year, silage.
Silage.
Without going to the shamba.
Anywhere.
Anywhere. 1 year.
And you talked about food banking.
Yes.
So right now as we talk, how much food do you have and for how long?
For now, we have now 8 months.
Food that you can feed these animals for 8 months?
For 8 months.
Just sitting.
We do it now and then. Actually, even today, we are still doing it.
So if you have to go off grid, somebody does anything to your neighbor in the farm, they stop bringing
eight
food.
Months.
8 months.
I'm comfortable.
Up and going.
Yes.
That is crazy, man.
It's not crazy. He's well organized.
Yeah.
Yes.
Planning.
Good planning. Good management. Good skills.
Wow.
And a passion in it.
You talked about having your hand in the farm, having them well trained. So, what are the challenges that come that?
Number one, a lot of farmers doesn't understand that the farm belongs to you. You are the boss, you are the manager. So whoever comes after you is an extra hand. And that extra hand, you need to look for somebody who has a passion for cows.
So it's hard to get someone.
If you employ somebody who just needs money, you get it wrong.
Wow.
So you need a person who has that skills in him and has a passion in dairy farming.
Yeah.
So that when you are away, he is also busy. And remember this. We tend to say workers, they go to the shamba to cut napier, to cut. That is not their work. That is your work.
Wow.
To manage the fodder.
Ah.
My work is to feed. Let them milk. We milk together. Ah. Milk is easier.
Milk is easier.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong.
When milking.
Yeah.
What about feeding?
But here you can go wrong.
If you go wrong here, then don't expect milk there.
And that is what keeps you afloat.
Yes.
We are here for the milk.
Yes. Not for manure.
Wow. We are seeing young people. You said dairy farming and keeping animals, okay? Now, because you're doing it to the best.
Yeah.
There's no better example that I have seen other than you. So you're the best person to advise young people. And other people, you're seeing them leaving Africa, okay? Leaving Africa, going abroad to do things, neglecting farming, looking down upon farming. So do you think agriculture and especially dairy farming is the future of Africa and doing it the way you're doing?
Actually, it was the future.
Yeah.
Before. But it was forgotten.
Wow.
Because people didn't take it seriously.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah.
And people thought dairy farming is a part-time job. The so-called, they call a side hustle. you have been employed elsewhere,
yeah,
but you have a farm.
Yeah.
What are you doing? No, I'm a banker, but I have a side hustle of dairy farming.
So that
this is not a side hustle.
This is the main hustle.
This is a business.
Wow.
Like other business.
Uh-huh.
It needs good management. It needs good recording.
Uh-huh.
Record keeping.
Mm.
It's good. It needs good inputs.
Yeah.
And outputs. Mm. Levels.
Mm.
You get that?
Yeah.
So this is a company on its own.
Mm.
Number one, your own man. This farm belongs to you. You do whatever you want to do at your pace.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay?
Yeah.
If you want to upgrade, you upgrade it at your own pace.
At your own pace.
You see, the good thing about dairy farming, if you don't feed them, you won't get milk. If you feed them,
you get milk. So after you've done all this, this venture is lucrative.
Yes.
It's better than that white collar job.
101%.
Okay, we've got that. Now, there's this wave of black diaspora. African Americans coming back to Africa. Africans in Europe, United Kingdom, coming back to Africa. Would you advise they take up on this venture? And you, and what I've seen here today, from the feed to the genetics to the management to the tech, you have something for them, training. So 1 minute, tell them something.
Actually, you are not the first, not the last person.
Mm.
People come from all over, even outside Kenya.
Wow.
Come here and I educate them.
Wow.
Because what I'm doing here,
yeah,
is not copy pasting information.
Yeah.
It's through my hands and my brain.
Wow.
You put them together,
you
have your own skills and techniques to raise a good farm like this. This is a training center where people come.
Mm.
They get more knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
From a calf to a heifer to a cow. Good management skills, good dairy keeping records, good skills for dairy farming, and above all, making your own feeds. You don't need to buy commercial feeds.
You make your own feeds.
You make your own.
You control the amount of milk you're producing.
Yes.
You don't have to complain later, oh, I bought poor feeds.
No.
Credible.
Good sourcing.
Credible.
Feed your cow right,
and
it will feed you right.
How much do you charge for trainings?
That's a very challenging question, tricky question. If you come as a team, you need to book area because of the program. I charge 1,000 per head.
1,000 per head.
1,000 per head.
What about that person who wants to come for training and they're not yet in the country? Are you able to offer online training?
We do online training.
Incredible. That's incredible.
That's where we are.
Yeah.
And also, I visit farm.
Mm-hmm.
I come to your farm. I see what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You see where we can improve and where are you going wrong.
I'll be sure. You guys, I'm going to put Josphat's number and all the details for the training in the description box. Make sure you get it there. Man, this is crazy. You're having even the chime. You see, where you're having like a group of people where you eat dinner, lunch, you keep those things that ding, ding, the wind makes music. You have that for your cows, man. Now, look, they're all resting.
Now they're resting.
Eating. Now they're waiting to, they're making no milk.
The third session.
For the third session.
For the milk.
This is incredible, man.
If you don't feed, your work is feed, they drink, they sleep, produce milk.
Folks, you can't make this stuff up. Now, if you've watched this video up until this point and you like it, remember to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up. It really goes a long way to helping this video. And remember, check out Josphat. I'm going to leave all the descriptions, all the details on the description box. Till the next one, a peace.